A very cool feature that was added into Flash Player 10.2 that you could take advantage of already right now. Even though there isn't a formal editor that supports it, you could work with some of the Flex or Flash Builder Flex SDKs, which are still work in progress. As long as you have Flash Builder, you could load that SDK. Now, what is these new Mouse OSs and what are their differences? What is the biggest difference between them and just the regular traditional way of doing it in Flash, which was basically hiding your operating system's mouse and taking control over it and creating an animation on your own or creating a drag on your own? One of the biggest problems with the way that it was done historically, I would say probably 8-9 years ago, maybe early 2000, it was very popular, those type of animations, and they kind of disappeared. You see them here and there, but almost you don't see them anymore, and one of the biggest reasons was they were very taxing on the operating system, and they were very taxing on Flash. And the reason was because, one, our operating systems are really, really great at keeping track of where your mouse is. That's what they do. And if they wouldn't, they would be in trouble. Well, Flash really, that wasn't never its main feature. And as Flash has other things that are running at the same time, hiccups were created. So if you had a frame rate of 10 or you had a frame rate of 20, but you're going crazy with your mouse would go, you would miss a lot of the fluidity and the detail of a mouse moving in your OS, just because it's not dependent on your Flash. So really, the whole goal of this new feature is to enable you to take advantage of this really, really cool feature that basically lets Flash send some bitmap data, lets it send some information to the OS, and lets the OS actually manage the animation and manage the fluidity of your mouse independently of what's happening inside of your Flash, which is really, really, really cool. All right, so our project, let's look at our project and start rolling. So we started off with our project. I just set here a little button that has a different cursor, which are all of these are our OS manages these cursors, and they're not dependent on our Flash. Now, if we run into our project, we'll see. We'll just scan through the file, and right for now, just ignore the errors because we're going to look into that in a second. As we start up our Mouse OS class, we're basically just creating a new button, setting it in the stage. As you've seen, we're calling this change default mouse. We have our empty change default mouse, which is going to be where we're going to be working in. And I've created some helper functions to help us cut down the amount of time of this video, which basically just create a new arrow, a very, very funky arrow, and convert that arrow into a bitmap while making sure that our bitmap is not larger than 32 by 32 pixels, because that is the max size of a cursor that the OS accepts. Now, obviously, most chances are you'll want a much smaller one, like a 16 by 16 or so, but we're going to work into the max environment. So let's get rolling and let's see how easy it is. So first of all, before we could actually do it, we have to make sure that we don't get these errors. And to do that, we have to make sure that we have an SDK that actually supports mouse cursor data. And that's really your key. So if you're working on Flash Builder and you see that you're getting an error here, that means you're working off of an SDK that just doesn't support it. And it's not the latest SDK, and you know, like, it might be later on after this video is out, but right now the SDKs are still in kind of like, some of them have some features, some of them have other features, they're not 100% stable. If you just right click into your project and go into your properties and change your SDK to be a specific SDK, which currently from the time this video was created was 4.5.0.19786, which was actually the build that was had that capability. So I'm going to click on apply and click OK. I'm going to be fine with updating our HTML to be HTML to Flash Player 10.2. And we can see that our mouse cursor data is not creating any errors anymore, and we could actually start working. Now, this segment obviously is very much only to this new days when this feature just came out. And the first thing that we want to do is we want to create a vector. And a vector is basically, it's just a simple, a more constrained array. And that's all we're going to talk about, the vectors. And if you don't know what vectors are, just do what we're doing right here. And just know that vectors are basically arrays, only a little bit more strict arrays. So I'm going to set my vector to be a vector, and it's going to be vector dot. And we're going to open up a bracket, and we're going to type what type of data it's going to contain. And it's going to contain bitmap data. We're going to set a new vector of type bitmap data, open close bracket. And let me just scroll down a bit. Now the next step is we want to actually feed into our vector, and I'm just going to position it in position 0. We're going to put inside of our vector a bitmap data. And because we already have a create arrow, we could just call our create and send to it a color. Let's say we'll send it red. And that's really all we have to do with our vector. The next step that we want to do is actually set up our MCD, which stands for our mouse cursor data, which is that new class that was added into Flash Player 10.2. And we could open and close our bracket and start setting our properties. So our MCD has a data, and we're going to set that data to be our vector. And we want to set for our MCD also a hotspot. And the hotspot is basically just going to tell the OS, this is our 0, 0 coordinate. This is the coordinate where we want the hit to happen in. So if we have an element that's 32 pixels by 32 pixels, and we wanted the hotspot to be in the center, then we would probably send it 16 on 16. But in our scenario, we're just going to send a new point at position 0, 0. That's all we really had to do to get our application rolling. And the next step for us is really just to actually register this new mouse cursor data. And to do that, we're going to use the mouse.registerCursor, and we're going to give it a name. Let's call it MCD. And we're going to send our MCD into it. And in the next stage, really, all we have to do is actually tell Flash, okay, now we want to use this cursor that we saved. So we could have obviously saved a few cursors if we wanted to. But in this scenario, in this sample, all we have to do is just change the cursor, set it to MCD, and run our application. And there you go. Our cursor is now very, very fast. It's disconnected from what's happening inside of Flash, and the OS is controlling it. So let's see how we could add some animations into this. And to do that, it's really, really easy. All we have to do is just add a few more elements into our vector. And for that, I'm just going to change a few colors here, keeping all the same stuff, and just changing some colors, creating three instances of that element. And really, we're already ready. All that's left is just adding one more property into our mouse cursor data, and basically just giving it a frame rate, because now that we're animating, we want to set a frame rate. And we want it to be the slowest frame rate as possible that we'll still be happy with. And for me right now, that would be 1 frames per second. And that's all we had to do to get our application to run an animation. And if I run it just one more time, we'll see that now our arrow is going to change colors. All right. Now, one more thing to note before we wrap this up. Last thing to note is obviously if we run this now and a user has an earlier version of Flash, they're going to get errors. They're going to get runtime errors. Why? Because these properties don't exist. But we want to make sure that before we call it, and that's why we set it into a separate function, we want to make sure that before we call it, we want to make sure that that property exists. And to make sure that that property exists, all we have to do is just call our mouse.supportsNativeCursor. And we know that our function will only be called if we support the native cursor. Now, this solves two issues. One, if explicitly our mouse is telling us, yes, I support it, that means we're already in a Flash player that supports it. Two, if we have a player that is 10.2 but doesn't support it, such as mobile devices or other types of formats that just don't support native cursors, then we wouldn't get any errors because we would block it before that happens. Now, because we're working in a very early release, different versions of the SDK, some of them have it, some of them don't. And because some of them have it, some of them don't, you might get errors. Especially if you're running a project and you're kind of switching between the SDKs to get things running. What you want to do is just basically just set here, instead of using a dot syntax, just bypassing the compiler for now. Bypassing, and all that really will do is make sure that your application will compile no matter what. And at runtime, if there would be runtime errors, then they would trigger. But the beauty about classes, if you try to approach something that doesn't exist in a class, and this is basically a class, it would return undefined. And by returning undefined, we're basically just ignoring this line, or more or less saying if false. So if false, then it would not call it. And the only time it would call is actually if our support native cursor would return a valid value, which is true. All right. So let's just run it one more time, see that everything is working. And now we could be safe to assume that if we'd run this on earlier versions of Flash, an error wouldn't happen. The regular behaviors would stay in place. And if we wanted to, we could have always implemented the drag feature, which I strongly recommend not to do that unless you really, really have to.